So, how are you doing? We're going to learn a classic 60s tune now called Wild Thing. It sounds like this. There you go. We're going to slow it down now. All right. So, and it's going to use all three of our new chords: G, C, and 9, and D. And I'm just going to play it for you, and then we'll explain how it works. If you might even just guess how it works just by watching. So here you go. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's a little bit different from how it sounds. I'm showing you like the singer-songwriter, open mic kind of guy version of it, okay? Because it's just a simple way of getting into playing songs. Right, so this is how it works. Now, we're going to count beats because it's a good idea to just learn about beats and all that as you go along. So it's counting in fours, and it goes like this. It goes 1, 2. So the first thing is to get that timing. First two beats are on G. Go G, G, and then you're going to count beat three, but you're not going to play on it. You're going to play on the and of beat three, and then on the beat four for the C add nine. So you're going to go G, G, F. Okay, so leave that little gap between those two chords. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that's the sort of upbeat. And four, but you can do all of this as downstrokes, not upstrokes in this song. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then the next bar is D, 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 back to C at 9, 3, and 4. So it's kind of in two halves with G and then C at 9, and then D and then C at 9. So it's nice, you're moving through back and forth between the chords. You can do it all again. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 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 Okay, and that's all there is to it, really. So you can practice that. Like I say, the tricky thing is getting that off beat. So you go 3 and 4. Okay, don't play on the beat three because you'll start, it'll just feel wrong. It won't feel like the song. But there you go. Now you are a 60s rock god.